extraordinary. You got a lot of press around perhaps bringing back the woolly mammoth. Now it's the dodo. You're raising serious money, Ben. Talk to us how you do it.
Well, I mean, for us, you know, as the world's first de-extinction company, I feel like the world actually is starting to pay attention not just to climate change and the effects that man is having on the environment, but loss of biodiversity is now at the forefront of a lot of conversations. You know, with COP15 and some of the great work that came out of the World Economic Forum, 50% of all biodiversity could go extinct between now and 2050. And we need better tools, we need better technologies. And so we decided to build a company, George Church and I, to build a biosciences and synthetic biology company called Colossal Biosciences, which focuses on leveraging CRISPR and other gene editing tools and technologies and advanced reproductive technologies in order to bring back these kind of iconic keystone species like the woolly mammoth, the Tasmanian tiger, and then obviously what we're announcing today is our avian genomics group focusing on the iconic dodo. And so our goal with this is to actually bring back these species, rewild them back into their natural habitat in partnerships with local governments and indigenous people groups and the broader public at large, and then leverage these tools and technologies both for human healthcare and then give all the technologies that we develop for conservation away to the world so that conservationists have more tools in fighting against loss of biodiversity.
It spawns so many other questions, and I'm sure many have got questions about why and how you bring them back into the now world. But I'm interested in the money part, the 150 million. What is the reward to investors here? Is it more about the application for people?
It is. And you know, what's interesting is that in science and in the great universities there are worldwide, a lot of times you'll start working on an individual paper or a problem, you'll publish a paper, and that's a great point solution. And some of those point solutions become incredible companies and incredible innovations for healthcare and for humankind as a whole. But what's really interesting is when you start to look at some of these big biology and synthetic biology problems as systems, a lot more innovations can come in a lot of different areas. So with just the mammoth, for example, we're working on computational biology, we're working on cellular engineering, we're working on stem cell reprogramming, and advanced gestational technologies. All of those can spur additional technology. So very similar to the like moon landing, or which was an actual moonshot, a lot of great technologies were developed that could completely transform the world, including fundamental technologies that allow us to have this conversation today. And so earlier this year, we actually spun out our first technology company called Form Bio, which was a computational biology platform that we developed because what we needed just didn't exist in the market. And we ended up raising $30 million for that. And that's a huge win for our investors.
Hey, Ben, you talked about the money. A source told us your valuation's now at around $1.5 billion. We asked our audience, is this a good use of funds? Here's what our audience thinks about that. Frankly, no. They think that, you know, research and funding can go into bigger problems. I'm going to ask you the same question as Caroline. What is the business model here? Jurassic Park?
No, so I mean, for us, it's about developing technologies, right? If you start to look at these things as systems problems, you actually can develop a lot of really great technologies. In our first 6 months of business, we developed a technology, raised $30 million for it, and it's a major technology and bioinformatics platform, which can be really helpful for human healthcare. And so what I would say is there's nothing more pressing than climate change and loss of biodiversity, and we need more tools. So it's on companies like us to educate the public on what the value of these tools are, not just to human healthcare and to investor returns, but to conservation.
Ben, we just have 30 seconds. There are concerns from paleogeneticists about de-extinction, a science question. Can you address them?
Yeah, I mean, we love negative feedback. I mean, for us, when you do anything big and bold in the world and you get all kinds of feedback, we love negative feedback. It's mainly if it's actually informed. So a lot of our earliest scientific advisors that were negative towards us, like Beth Shapiro, is now, you know, talking to the world today about the dodo. She was actually one of our biggest voices of opposition when we started. Same thing with Lou Vidal. And so we have a policy that we actually run towards critical feedback, because we want to do things the most transparent in the best way possible. And so you can do that by really listening to feedback that you get from the general public.